Oakland Raiders. You can see 100 yards difference in the rushing attack, yards per game for the Washington Huskies. And going against this USC defense in that second quarter, the Huskies had four possessions. They all ended in four punts. This is the best defense in the conference, and if you cannot run the ball, you're going to have a very long afternoon.
Yeah, I know the game has turned into one of pitch and catch, but you simply cannot control the tempo of the ball game if you can't run it.
Well, the offensive linemen, if they're always back pass blocking, they lose that power up front. And what you're seeing on both teams today, the offensive linemen are not creating any space for the running backs to get through.
Now we'll look at our Pacific Life game summary.
And just to emphasize the rushing yardage, you can see that 5 yards rushing for Washington, and former starting tailback Rich Alexis has yet to carry the ball today. We should see more of him in the second half because obviously Chris Singleton and Braxton Clement not getting the job done.
The Trojans will kick off. The Huskies will receive it. Ryan Killeen is back on the field to do the kicking, and there's conversation between Steve Sarkisian and Carson Palmer. Sarkisian is the former player from BYU and was coached by Norm Chow, who is the offensive coordinator at Southern California. Here are the Trojans kicking off. And the Huskies back up into the end zone. Frederick watches it go beyond the field of play. And now we'll check in with Todd Harris.
The coach has said coming into this game you needed to find a hot back. It doesn't look like you found it. What's game two now?
Well, we've got to see if we can still establish some form of running so we just don't get one-dimensional. But obviously, we've got to start making some plays. They're kind of got an envelope over the top of us. We've got to see if we can puncture it a little bit.
You got a great number one out there and a good quarterback. Time to let it go?
Yeah, we need to try a little bit and see if we can get the ball down the field.
Okay, that obviously recorded a few minutes ago. The game is underway now as Washington comes up first down on their own 20-yard line. Cody Pickett in the first half. Some success, but not enough. Turns and hands the ball to Chris Singleton, who's in there at the tailback position. They've got a fellow named Kenny James on this football team as a tailback, but they don't want to use him. They want to keep him for the future. There are the numbers of Cody Pickett in the first half.
His favorite receiver has been Reggie Williams, 4 catches for 58 yards. But Neuheisel talked about that envelope. That means he's facing a zone defense in SC. They do not want to let number one get deep.
Second down and 7 for the Huskies. Pickett, play action, looks left, goes right high. Incomplete, intended for Eddie Jackson.
Broken up by Darryl. Reggie Williams in the first half, especially in the first quarter, was very effective against Marcel Allman. But this is when SC was playing more man-to-man pass defense. You can see his ability after the catch. The SC changed to more zone, and that has been more effective in preventing the big play to Reggie Williams.
Third down and 7 now for the Huskies. Singleton, the single back. Pickett looking to throw. Ball slapped loose. Ball's on it. Covers it. Protects it. And that's going to be fourth down and long. And here again, Todd.
Well, Keith, follow this under, believe it or not, at halftime, Washington quarterback Cody Pickett was complaining that he felt the balls were overinflated. So they had the official check them, and like that high school you mentioned a few weeks ago in Montana, sure enough, they were overinflated. Right now, that doesn't seem to be his problem.
Fourth down and 13 for the Huskies. I don't know. What does an overinflated ball do, Dan?
Well, obviously, it does not fit his hand as a regularly inflated ball would. I've heard of balls being deflated, but never overinflated.
Pretty hard. Ball is fair caught back at the 37-yard line by Greg Carlson, and the Trojans have good field position for their first possession of the second half. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Pontiac, fuel for the soul. The Hartford, always thinking ahead. And Miller High Life, to live simply, proudly, boldly, manly. This is the High Life. The autumn haze, as we're wont to say out here, covering Southern California today, at least the Los Angeles basin.
the Trojans on first down will throw the ball. Carson Palmer throws to the short zone, goes to Alex Holmes, his tight end. And the big fella is going to have a first down. Alex, 265 pounds of trouble from Sherman Oaks when he's got a football tucked under his arm.
A heck of a catch by Alex Holmes.
Here he is, right, lined up right here, just a down and out route from the tight end position. Ball's going to be thrown just a little bit behind him. Watch him reach back, one hand, corral it, drag Ben Madavi forward for the first down for SC.
Incidentally, that halftime score at Oregon and Arizona State, it's the Ducks 21 and Arizona State 10 now. The Sun Devils mounting something of a comeback, and Sultan McCullough almost broke that. He was very close to getting out into the open field and causing some trouble. In the open field, he is very difficult.
He showed last week that he's starting to develop a more elusive running style as he hits across that left side of the offensive line. One cut and then go. Madavi with a long gainer stopping tackle.
Palmer throws. That's good. It's caught by Mike Williams on a slant pattern, and Williams will go down at the 30-yard line and easily a first down for USC. Jimmy Newell made the tackle.
Mike Williams had a rough start to his afternoon, dropping this pass into the hands of Sam Cunningham on the first play of the game. Then he dropped this one, but then Norm Chow went right back to him. Next possession, 9-yarder on the hitch route, and then the 43-yard bomb as he gets behind the entire Husky secondary for the touchdown.
And it's first and 10 Trojans, Husky 30. Palmer gives it to McCullough. The idea, of course, is to pound on them. Well, they're pounding, but the other guys are pounding right back.
Yeah, and part of the pounding is to control the tempo of the game. You can see SC is taking their time getting back to the huddle, getting the play called. It's now, with this type of field position, you know you're in field goal range. That ground game will help control the clock.
Second down and 9. Palmer to Holmes. Holmes juked one man, got away from him. It's McKenzie, Malofo McKenzie. And McKenzie, who is a running back by trade and is fast becoming very effective receiver.
Yeah, they moved him to the fullback position. And he is the top receiver as a running back in the conference. Multiple skilled young man. 6-year senior. Picking up a nice gain there on second down. All the receiving yards that Malifo has made this year out of the backfield.
Single back, McCullough. Contact. Miller came across for Washington.
And that'll be a first down. If he wasn't drawn off.
About 3rd and 2.5. So the offside will give him a first down, but Washington.
Keith, that's some of that experience of Carson Palmer. As a quarterback, you can tell when they're over-anxious.
On the defense. 5-yard penalty. Yardage result on the first down.
So the Huskies begging the case, but to no good. It goes against them, and it'll be first down USC next Saturday. A doubleheader for you starting at 9 o'clock in the morning, Pacific time. The Fighting Irish of Notre Dame and Florida State. And then at 12:30 Pacific time, you'll have the same Trojans up in Eugene against the University of Oregon Ducks, who are ranked number 6 starting play today. This McKenzie. And he had a pretty good rip on a guy to get McCullough almost again out of there. Sultan is now getting closer and closer to popping something big.
Yeah, he's one tackler away from getting in the end zone. A little misdirection here. Cutback run. The hole opens up there behind tight end Greg Gunther, but Jimmy Newell is there to fill it.
Speaking of Gunther, he has not seen the ball today. The big 6'8", 240-pound sophomore from Calabasas. Haven't really needed his pass-catching skills as yet. There's the pursuit on Carson Palmer. He gets away from The Heat, he goes out of bounds after picking up about 3 yards. Anthony Kelly, number 47, was the man pursuing him.
You know, that's probably the biggest improvement that Palmer has made this year is his ability to make something happen when the protection breaks down. He's an excellent athlete. Terrific speed for a man his size, 6'6", 230. And he got away from a very determined Anthony Kelly that time.
Kareem Kelly is on the field now. Mike Williams will be to the right or to the bottom of the picture, and Kareem Kelly is up at the top. And on third down, Palmer looks into the end zone and throws. Touchdown, Mike Williams.
Touchdown catch of the day for Mike Williams, working the slant route against Derek Johnson, and Palmer standing tall in the pocket. Watch as he gets to the inside. It's all over right there. Ball on target, but that move there, Johnson cannot allow a man with that size and speed to get off clean inside like that.
Killeen for the extra point. It's good. 9:34 to go in the third quarter, and Southern California opens up a 24-7 lead as they go 63 yards, 9 plays, 3 minutes and 52 seconds.
We'll be there.
From John Woo, director of Mission Impossible 2 and Face Off, starring Academy Award winner Nicolas Cage.
My responsibility!
A full-throttle, heart-pounding action thriller.
Get out of here!
Wind Talkers. Buy or rent it today. Introducing three grilled favorites on one sizzling skillet. Chili's new fajita trio. Marinated chicken fajitas, spicy shrimp, and barbecued ribs.
Chili's.
The best part is that look on their faces when they see how many miles I have on it.
Take pride in your odometer with Valvoline's Max Life. It helps keep higher mileage engines running for a long, long time.
Wednesday and my wife and kids, it's
Attack of the Loser Boyfriend.
You can call me Tim Foti, EZ.
My wife and kids, 8, 7 Central, ABC Wednesday.
At 9:34 to go in the third quarter, the Huskies better be careful. This one could get away from them real quickly. High, deep kickoff by Killeen. My gosh, it didn't hit the ground until it was beyond the field of play.
He's the freshman, true freshman. Mike Williams is the Trojans' second leading receiver at 6'5". He combines size, speed, and big play ability, and he's now the Trojans' number one offensive weapon. He's averaging 20 yards per catch today. Been in the end zone a couple of times. And his coach and quarterback have a lot of faith in him coming back after having a rough start this afternoon. And he's out dueling that other number one, Reggie Williams.
Pickett quickly throws. Pass is completed. Gain is about 8 yards to Patrick Reddick, who makes his first catch of the day. He's another Southern Californian, comes from Newberry Park. The Oregon Ducks have gone to 28-10 now over Arizona State. Up in Eugene. Washington State, the other undefeated team in conference play, is off healing this weekend. Second down and two. It's Singleton. He's close. The Pac-10 standings coming into the ball game. One at the top is off. Oregon can go to 3-0 with a win. Arizona State could be absorb their first loss in the conference. But it's not over. And like Yogi said, ain't over till it's over. Trojans would go to 3-1. UCLA's playing at California later this afternoon. And the Bruins need to be careful, too. Third down and very short for the Washington Huskies now. They need about a foot. And Cody Pickett, the quarterback, keeps it and dives ahead. And he went over the left side of the center, and he got it.
First down, Huskies.
5 weeks in a row at home for Washington. It was kind of, everybody thought it might be kind of exhilarating for them to go on the road and play a game. But so far, the exhilaration has been muted.
Yeah, I never thought it was a good idea to go on the road and play a game. I always kind of liked sleeping in my own bed and driving to the game instead of flying.
You got to get in there and scuffle with some tough folks to hone your team, and the Huskies had some pretty easy games. Cody Pickett's pass is to a wide open Kevin Ware, the tight end, and he is brought down finally down near the 30-yard line by Deshaun Hill. If Hill misses him, he's gone.
That is a great tackle by Deshaun Hill, because 255-pound Kevin Ware was running full speed. Time to throw is the key again for Pickett. Here's Ware, top of the screen there, and it's a little out and up from the tight end position. He loses the linebacker. Ball is well delivered, and there's that fine tackle by Hill.
And it's first down, obviously, for the Huskies down at the Southern California 31-yard line. Pickett back, throwing again, gets it away. Ball is incomplete. Marcel Aumann had a shot at it as they tried to force it into Reggie Williams, and it was incomplete.
Pickett had a lot of pressure on him that time. He's going to get drilled after he lets it go. That's why the ball is thrown so far behind Reggie Williams and almost intercepted by Marcel Aumann. Keith, the combination of Allman's physical play at the line of scrimmage and Pete Carroll switching up defenses has kept Reggie Williams under control.
And Allman is another one of the wide receivers who's gone to a defensive back position. There goes Singleton out of the backfield. It's an empty backfield. A little quick pop is thrown. Intercepted! It's Matt Grootegood. And he's out of bounds, down around the 26-yard line. And there's a penalty flag thrown back up the field, probably blocking in the back. But that ball bounced right off the hands of Patrick Reddick and right into Grootegood. Well, let's see about the flag.
First interception of the year for Matt Grootegood. He was in the right place at the right time. Again, little zone coverage as he drops back. Reads the quarterback's eyes, looks inside. There's the ball thrown on time, but it just appeared that Reddick wasn't ready for it. It was one of those pop passes. Pickett saw he was uncovered, and that's when you know things are not going your way as a quarterback. You read the coverage, you know who you're going to, and the timing is just not there. But the ball was there for Grootegood.
Well, it's a chop block on the Huskies, blocking below the waist.
And you may say, well, why are they blocking? Well,
illegal block below the waist on the original offense. Penalty being forced 15 yards from the end of the run. Half the distance is the goal, end of the run. First down.
Wow. That's on the original pass blocking. That penalty occurred, and it's tacked on to the end of the return.
That is a rough one.
Yeah, it just looked like Washington was starting to find a rhythm on offense. They got the big play down the middle to Ware. They converted a third down on the quarterback sneak. And now this.
That'll ground your balloon pretty quickly, I would think, because that is a dramatic swing, not only with the interception, but to have half the distance penalty nailed on you. And here's USC now camped at the Washington 13-yard line, first down. M- McCullough gives the ball to Kerry Colbert, and Colbert cuts back into traffic, and Kerry gets down to the 11, and he's hopping mad because he didn't go far. Here's John Saunders to update you on that Oregon game up in Eugene against Arizona State.
Keith, as you saw, the score, Oregon with the lead, and here adding to it, here's how it happened. Ontario Smith, this is his third touchdown run of the game from 6 yards out. He's well over 100 yards. Arizona State just scored. The extra point is pending. It's up. It's good. So now 28-17.
Josh Miller shaken up on the field for the Huskies. He's one of the interior linemen for them, and he's down on the field injured. Arizona State proves again, though, they can strike from long range. They can really air that thing out sometimes with Sean McDonald and Lightfoot and those people. And
especially against the Oregon pass secondary, which is probably the only liability that Oregon has right now. Carson Palmer back in 1998 got his first start against the Washington Huskies wearing number 15. He made the most of the opportunity, completed 18 of 31 for 279, a touchdown, and no interceptions. Most important stat was the final score. USC dominated 32-10 here at the Coliseum. Having another good afternoon against the Huskies.
On second down and 8. Throwing in the middle, Williams, touchdown. Three touchdowns for Mike Williams. Wow. That's sort of in your face, Reggie.
Another ingenious play by Norm Chow. Watch Williams come to the inside, Colbert to the outside. A little confusion here as he gets a little bit of a rub there. But the zone defense is going to bite the Huskies as they drop too deep. Williams can get in the end zone.
The point is good. So it's now 31-7, Southern California, and we're still in the third quarter. 6:56 to go.
They've worked hard to get here. Persistence, performance, strength, it all paid off. So how do achievers secure their future? They do what nearly two-thirds of the Fortune 500 do. They put their confidence in the Pacific Life family of companies. With over 130 years of experience and $340 billion in managed assets, secure your course in life. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
Fleet of airships, which reminds you to take all of life's journey on the wings of Goodyear. Nice soft afternoon for a ride in an airship. Ontario Smith, incidentally, up in that Oregon game, is now his seventh consecutive game over 100 yards. And again, Colleen has kicked the ball far and away and no return.
Yeah, at some point, the NCAA is going to have to look at moving the kickoff back. There is a flag down. Apparently, SC was offsides on that kickoff, so we'll move the ball back 5 yards back to the 30. They're just not getting any kickoff returns in college football anymore.
25 seconds. Scoring on an 11-yard touchdown pass. Carson Palmer.
I'm Rick Neuheisel. I'm saying kick it again. We got to generate something. Maybe our special teams can add a spark here. We get a big kickoff return.
On the kicking game.
So they're going to redo it. Try to hope they get something out of it. Look at this. Arizona State climbing back into the hunt. It's now 28-17. Oregon.
So from the 35, Killeen will try it again, the sophomore from Norco.
Had a pretty good leg.
Yeah, moving it back five, it'll be interesting to see if he can reach the end zone. He's been putting it deep from the 35, but this could make a big difference here.
He gets too wound up in it and swings at it too hard, he might whip it. Kind of like hitting a golf ball, you know, if you really try to bust it, it's easy to miss.
Not with that new driver of yours, it's not.
Oh, my goodness, it's a knuckleball coming down the field. It's fielded on the 25-yard line. He did miss it. It fumbled. But it looked like a Husky got on it in a hurry. Kevin Ware was the fellow who picked it up. And tonight, we were talking earlier about this, tonight at 7 Pacific time, Notre Dame and Air Force, both of them 6-0, will go at it over at Colorado Springs. 7 o'clock at night up in the Rocky Mountains. That's got to be cold. Ball will be hard. It'll be 10 o'clock Notre Dame's bedtime. It'll be interesting to see what a wishbone football team can do in today's marketplace. So far, they've done very well, thank you. Braxton Clemen, the tailback, but the ball is deflected at the line of scrimmage as Cody Pickett tried to throw on a slant pattern.
Really got to start feeling sorry for Cody Pickett with absolutely no rushing attack. He's being forced to go back and try to find a receiver. That time he looked for Reggie Williams, but the defensive line of SC continues to play well, knocking that one down before it could get anywhere.
And in case you missed it, Sean Cody is gone for the season. Big tackle for SC.
Ball is intercepted. Picked off by Polamalu. He's still going. Sore ankle and all. He doesn't feel a bit of pain as he goes inside the 15-yard line where Pickett knocks him out of bounds.
Last year he had a 22-yard interception return for a touchdown, and he was darn determined that time to bring that one back. Pickett throwing into the teeth. Here's Polamalu. Watch him come over here, reading the quarterback's eyes, and he's going to take this ball in full stride. Makes one miss there. Charles Frederick. Polamalu is a very severely sprained, one of those high ankle sprains on his right foot. He looks 100% here. Watch him punish the quarterback at the end of the run.
He's a warrior. He felt no pain. He might tomorrow, but not now. Palmer, penalty flag down as Palmer throws complete. Ball goes to Sultan McCullough. He runs it into the end zone, but hold the phone. The referee threw the flag.
Got two on the field, Keith. One of the line judge also
against USC.
They both saw that illegal formation or illegal shift.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty, previous spot, still first down.
So that puts a little bit of damp on the Trojan celebration that was a building as the ball comes back five to the just outside the 17-yard line.
First down and 15.
Oregon's gone back in front, added another touchdown to make it 35-17.
Were they playing volleyball up there?
Yeah, Arizona State, they got a great passing game when it's working. And ball is thrown here at to the outside. He's out of bounds right there on the 13-yard line. It's Grant Matos getting his first catch of the day. Senior wide receiver.
And one side note for the SC wide receivers. Remember, Kareem Kelly has a bad right ankle, did not start today. Mike Williams is taking over for him and played very well. Kelly looking for one catch.
He's out there right now, Dan.
But he has no catches yet.
So he comes to the right side, or the bottom of the picture, has the wide out. Palmer goes the other way. Oh, he hands it off. And here comes McCullough, and a penalty flag is thrown by the referee. Holding the Trojans. It's holding against Southern California. Now let's have a look at what happened up in Oregon with John Saunders.
Keith, the score you were just talking about against Arizona State, Jason Fife goes 50 yards to George Reister. A great grab as he leaps up to get it, then fights off the tackle, and then just stays behind the one block he needs to get it in for the touchdown. Oregon is rolling over Arizona State now 35-17, Keith.
Ontario Smith, 130 yards, huh?
Yeah. Jason Fife.
Looking better and better, isn't he?
Yeah, and really playing with all the pressure of following the legendary Joey Harrington. Not having any trouble at all.
It's the system.
Second down and 21. Number 23.
You can see what a system does. This quarterback, Carson Palmer, and this SC offense, a lot better in the second year under Norm Chow's system.
Caught by Kerry Colbert, and the tackle made by Chris Massey. But Jason Fife sat on the bench, what, for 2 years, right, behind Harrington. And by the time his opportunity to play came, he'd been pretty well seasoned and was ready.
Doesn't hurt having a running attack, too, like Ontario Smith provides.
Yeah, you're right.
Carson Palmer, hot quarterback here in the second half, but that offensive line has totally nullified the Husky pass rush.
Mike Williams left the field, and I don't know whether it's cramp or something with his left leg. They're talking about it. So he's off the field right now on third down and 14. Palmer gets pursuit, gets away from it, throws it in the end zone. A wide open man drops the ball. Kerry Colbert, who is normally a very steady receiver, was in the air and just simply dropped it.
Ball went right through his hands and put an X on his chest. Tight spiral by Carson Palmer, buying time. He goes over and whacks his receiver. He knows this is not going to happen very often. Look at this throw on the run.
It happens.
He was into his celebratory dance, maybe.
33-yard field goal try coming now with Killeen. And the kick is good. And the Trojans now make it a 34-7 ball game, having lost the touchdown, but having the opportunity for three. Now time for Todd's Traveling Expo.
All right, Keith. Well, it's not Halloween quite yet, but I'm in the middle of Paula Malu's posse. These are the guys that follow Troy around. They're big fans. What we want to talk about this week is the high ankle sprain. Now, I know you hear a lot about it. The difference between the high ankle sprain and regular ankle sprain is a normal ankle sprain, the ankle just rolls over this way. The high ankle sprain, these two bones separate from the tendon tear, and when you step down on the talus, that's when the bones really get a lot of pain to the player like Troy Polamalu. He's playing with it by virtue of this beautiful brace that was custom made to his foot. And I'll tell you what, Russ Romano and John Taper Dean, the athletic trainers, have got him in good shape, as you saw by that last interception. But here it is, Polamalu's posse. Back to you.
I like it, Keith. I think we'll get you one of those for your birthday.
That's a rather exotic setting for a medical dissertation, wouldn't you think?
How about that high ankle sprain, 33 yards on the return? You don't want one of those wigs, huh?
No.
Todd, bring that one upstairs.
Todd, you take that home. Kerry will take a stick to you. She won't let you in.
By the way, we do want to wish you the happiest of two over par birthdays.
I've already had them. I've been having it all week. Flat worn out. I can't wait to get home.
Again, the ball is through the end zone and beyond the field of play and will come out to the 20-yard line. So the Huskies have seen a lot of that 20-yard line territory today. 34-7, the Trojans have the lead. Claxton is your running back or tailback. And it's set up in a single back formation with two doubles, two wides on the bottom and one at the top of your picture. Whistles again, stopping it. Jay Strickerts is your referee today.
Dead ball, false start, on the up, 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Let's go for a moment to John.
Keith, Ohio State, watch a nice fake to Maurice Claret. Krenzel goes to Ben Hartsock, and that's good for the touchdown. They go for the two-point conversion, did not get it. So right now, the Buckeyes lead the Badgers 19-14 with about 10 minutes left.
The old Cam Randall gig, that's a tough place to play. They really get on your back.
And yeah, with only a five-point lead.
Yep. We're still in the third quarter in this one with Southern California holding all the controls right now. They swing it out to Clemens out of the backfield, and a penalty flag is thrown with the linesman across the way. False start, Washington.
This team's starting to unravel. Two penalties already on just this possession alone.
Well, they have had their distractions at the University of Washington this year. No question about that. A continuing nagle from and the eventual decision from the NCAA was got to be a black cloud.
And that cloud is going to hang around for a while.
It looks like it. Second down and 12. Pressure coming. They got him. Number 53 and number 94 are the two people who came pounding in to make the play. I thought I saw 53. And Udazi again involved because he's had almost a free afternoon over there at his defensive position.
10 yards on the sack.
So they get a couple of penalties, push him back, and now a 10-yard sack by number 94, Kenechi Udazi. And it's all him. I think your 53 was really 93. Bernard, yeah. Riley, yeah. Flying in there. So the loss of Sean Cody, not as bad as the Trojans may have feared.
Third and 22. Pickett gets away from the first pressure and throws down the sidelines, and no chance on the play. None at all for Frederick to make the catch. And Udazi again had the lasso out for Cody Pickett. Right now, Washington is being manhandled by the Trojans. Well, as long as they can keep Bernard Riley healthy, you know, he used to be the starter in that defensive front, but he's been dinged up quite a bit lately. But if they can keep him healthy, he'll be all right.
Yeah, they've got a lot of confidence in him. He's a senior, and he works well with Mike Patterson on some of those twists.
McLaughlin now out of the end zone to punt for Washington. Oh, that's a dandy. It's really high. A lot of air under it. It's going to be fielded right about the 50 midfield stripe, and that is not an intrusion of the halo by Wilbur Hooks this time. And Wilbur got his shot. It'll be SC ball at the 50.
Tread lightly, son-in-law. There are more traps lying ahead than in the deep woods of Montana. One false step, and she'll have your head mounted on her parlor wall. That's the right idea. keep light on your feet, and you just might emerge from this encounter in one piece. Good thing there's also a light way to live. The high life.
Taco Bell's grilled steak taco tastes so authentic, you may exhibit carne asada bravado.
Carne asada steak tacos, ladies?
Yeah.
It's an old family recipe.
Really? Yeah.
I did. I made it myself.
I thought he was Irish.
Shh. He's on a roll.
The grilled steak taco. Tender slices of steak marinated in Mexican spices and grilled to perfection for a taste that's irresistible. For authentic carne asada steak, think outside the bun.
Champion is crowned.
Go.
The 2002 MLS Cup, New England Revolution, LA Galaxy, tomorrow on ABC.
Time for our Pontiac Drive summary. USC's possessions here in the second half. You can see, even when you go backwards, you can still get something out of it. It's been all SC here in the second half. Justin Vargas is the deep back for Southern California. They come out throwing. There's Kareem Kelly's catch. So he keeps the pace of catches in consecutive games with the other two folks. One of them being Keenan Howry, who's involved in the ball game up in Eugene.
Yeah, and it's a very safe pass. Just a hitch route. Kelly looks pretty good, actually, for having so much tape on that right ankle that's very sore. If I were Pete Carroll right now, I'd take his helmet away from him, start to unwrap that ankle, put some ice on it, because he's got a big week next week against Keenan Howry and the Ducks.
Kia Northcutt of Arizona is the man who holds that record, and somebody's going to break it this year. In fact, maybe both of them will break it. This is Justin Vargas carrying to the right side on the first down, and didn't quite get to the line of scrimmage. Here's John Saunders again.
Arizona State and Oregon, and it looked like the Ducks had things in control, but back comes Arizona State. Andrew Walter, 3 yards to Mike Pinkert for the touchdown. They've just added another long touchdown pass. And so Oregon, which looked like they're rolling away now, lead by only 5. Keith.
That liability in the secondary for Oregon's killing them. Remember what Stanford did to them last year.
Yep. Second down and 10. Sun Devils went for 2, so that's a pretty close ball game now. 35-32 is your score up in Eugene, Oregon. Here it's 34-7, Southern California, and in control of the ball game. Third down and 9 coming up.
Here's 1 yard. Third and 9. 33.
Well, Oregon's got 2 of the smallest corners in the conference.
And they were lucky to escape last week's game against UCLA, the Rose Bowl.
That's right. Palmer going to the corner. Williams, no. Defending it is Jimmy Newell.
Well, up to that great play by Jimmy Newell, Mike Williams has had a pretty good second half. 3 catches, 43 yards. 2 touchdowns, and his 3 touchdown receptions on the afternoon ties a SC record.
And we're at 1:45 in the third quarter, and he just missed on this last one. It's 4th and 9, and they're going for it. Palmer's got a man right down the pipe, and he was late getting the ball to him. George Gunther, the big tight end, 6'6", was open early, and Palmer didn't see him in time, and by the time he threw it, there was a defender there to mess it up.
Yeah, Gunther was wide open, Keith, as you said. Palmer was looking down the field away from him. Here's Gunther right here. He's going to come right down the middle here.
And then number 21, Derek Johnson, is going to come out of nowhere from the right side of the screen and almost pick that ball off.
The attendance today is 52,961. I'm sure that's less than what they anticipated for this particular ball game. But those who are not here probably are saying, uh-huh, see how smart I am. Now I can put my feet up and watch the Angels play in the World Series tonight. Ball is thrown short underneath, and it goes to Zach Tuiasosopo, the fullback out of the backfield, the younger brother of Marcus. And he gets the ball for the first time today and makes it count. Monday night up in Pittsburgh, it will be the Colts, Indianapolis Colts, against the Pittsburgh Steelers at 6 Pacific. And don't forget to cast your vote for Monday Night Football's greatest game at ESPN.com. Your keyword, MNF500 or NFL.com. Second down, Chris Singleton trying to pick up the first down on second down and three, and he didn't get it.
Now, these numbers for the running attack is just, it's pathetic, really. Clemens, 10 yards on seven carries. Singleton, 1 yard on six carries. And Rich Alexis, with a bad ankle, not playing at all today.
Reggie Williams is coming down wide to the left, along with Paul Arnold. But Pickett goes the other way. The ball is caught by Frederick. Frederick breaks loose and will pick up a first down for Washington as he gets the ball down to the Southern California 43.
You know, sometimes when you're having trouble with your offense, you find two receivers in one area and throw the ball at both of them, and maybe one of them will catch it. And that's what happened to the Cody Pickett that time, as Kevin Ware and Charles Frederick in the same area. But if they can get Frederick going, they might have a chance. You know, I mean, this kid's got big playability. Keith Gilbertson said he reminds him of a fast Mario Bailey. Remember how good he was for the Dogs.
Quarter's over. We got one to go. ABC Sports presentation of college football. Back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Great inspiration. We'll be there.
The Disney Golf Classic. Tiger Woods heads the field Sunday, 4 Eastern on ABC.
I could tell by the picture that I could build it, so why send away for the plans?
You got that right.
Right.
How do you keep this perfect temperature?
Oh, well, I got the barbecue from the backwoods. And I have it going underneath the tub and keeps it nice and bubbly and warm.
It is hot.
What's that? It'll settle down. What do you say we go grab a Henry?
When you're drinking Henry's, everything's worth toasting.
Is that your leg?
Can you give me a little room, buddy?
Yeah.
Turning raw metal into pure gold isn't easy. Unless it's Chevy Truck Month with $500 bonus cash. Use $500 bonus cash to lease an S10 Extreme Extended Cab for as low as $199 a month with $35.99 due at lease signing. Residency restrictions apply. Call for important lease details. It's a new gold rush on durable, long-lasting Chevy trucks. Stake your claim. $500 bonus cash ends October 31st. Visit us online or see your Northwest Chevy dealer.
First for local news, Kathy Gertson, Como 4 News.
The final 15 minutes coming up here as the ball rests just on the Southern California 43-yard line, possessed by the Washington Huskies, first down and 10. Huskies have been very quiet since the first quarter. They scored a touchdown to make it to take the lead, actually, and since they've done nothing since. The ball is thrown to Chris Singleton out of the backfield for a gain of about 6 yards.
Our Pacific Life game summary has been all about offense and defense for SC. Second touchdown catch of the day for Reggie Williams, then a Matt Grotegood interception led to the third touchdown catch for Williams. And then a Troy Polamalu pass interception and 33-yard return set up a field goal, and it's been all Trojans in the second half.
Second down call at 5. Pickett throwing, going deep for Wilbur Hooks. And Wilbur looked left, and he went over his right shoulder, Daryl Rideau defending.
And it's funny how when you're looking over your shoulders, how much it slows you down. If he had an idea where the ball was, we've seen earlier in the day when Carson Palmer threw the bomb to Mike Williams, how he just could run straight ahead, not have to look over his shoulder. That ball thrown a little bit to the backside. That's why Hooks couldn't get to it. That's the world's biggest hibachi.
That ball is thrown outside to Braxton Clemen. He'll go down to about the 30-yard line, and that will be good for a Husky first down as Deshaun Hill makes the tackle. Do you know what that cost?
Per minute? That's a lot of gas. Did those Enron folks running that one?
I don't know. It's a lot, though, I imagine. But still a great landmark in this city. 1932 Olympics, 1984 Olympics.
Pickett's pass. Reggie Williams inside the 5, down at the 2, first and goal for the Huskies. First catch in a long time for Reggie Williams, but he gets off inside against Marcel Allman. He's so effective on these slant routes, scored 3 times on a similar type of route last week against Arizona. And Pickett with one of his best throws of the day as the Huskies 2 yards away from a touchdown.
Well, in the fourth quarter, they've been known to work some pretty magic stuff in the fourth quarter. Pickett rolls out, throws, he's got him wide open. Kevin Ware, the tight end, for the touchdown. So they'll have the point now to try to make it a 20-point ball game.
And it's amazing, as poorly as Washington runs the ball, this play-action fake holds the Trojans' defense, and Ware is wide open. Watch, they're going to fake the ball up here. Here's Ware, just down and out. And with the rollout, Pickett could just about walk this one in.
Kick's good. John Anderson makes it a 34-14 ball game with 13 minutes and 30 seconds left to play at the Los Angeles Coliseum.
Can connect with the office network when they're away, right from a PCS phone. Exchange email, contacts, and calendars, just like on a computer, instantly.
You mean I
couldn't have said it better myself.
Introducing PCS Vision from Sprint. See the power behind the PCS Clear Wireless Workplace.
Let's go.
Dave, you heard about the new initiative? It's about cost cutting?
Yes.
Then why did we install all these new servers?
Well, to cut costs. You see, with Dell, everything's more flexible. These PowerEdge servers use Intel Xeon processors, so we don't get locked into proprietary technology. And that cuts costs.
Smart move, Dave. We could use you in accounting. Call me.
Find out how you can cut costs across your enterprise. Easy as Dell. Call or go online today.
Ever try talking to your dad during football?
Would it kill you to take the time to listen to me?
I always have time to listen to you, just not right now.
Eight simple rules. Join the fun. ABC Tuesday.
Well, there's a little lift for the Huskies as their team comes in here to in the fourth quarter to get a touchdown and make it a 20-point ball game, 34-14. A lot of things have followed this Washington team across the fourth quarter in recent seasons. But they needed to be a little closer, I think, than this. That's a high hanger that goes beyond the field of play. ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Cadillac. Bold vehicles defying convention. Old Navy Painter's Pants, the handyman's classic. And Valvoline's Max Life, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines.
Keith, Husky defense needs a turnover. They need a takeaway. They got to get the ball
something
back. And they haven't been real good at that this year. Ninth in the conference in turnover ratio. They have one interception today, but that was on the very first pass, very first play of the game from Carson Palmer.
Palmer throws outside very quickly, going one-on-one with Mike Williams, and Williams is good for 9 yards on the play. Cunningham making the tackle. Now again quickly, John Saunders.
Keith, this one's hard to believe. Oregon led this game 21-0 and 35-17 in the second half. Andrew Walton of Arizona State, 58 yards to Justin Taplin for the touchdown. The tackle comes too late. And Arizona State leads the unbeaten Ducks 39-35.
Wow. 12 minutes to play, huh?
Andrew Walker's got a great long arm, doesn't
he? Well, he does. He's got a howitzer. Palmer turns. Penalty flag goes down as Justin Farkas gets the carry for about 3 yards. So Arizona State has taken the lead by 4. Ooh-wee.
Yeah. 12 minutes to go up there in Eugene. Probably got time for 6 or 7 more scores.
Arizona State will have they'll have Washington next at Tempe and then at defense. Washington State.
5 yard penalty. Still second down.
That's a 5 yard penalty against the Huskies, so move it along and make it first down at the 35-yard line. .13-12 to play in the ball game. Trojans don't want to get too conservative here and then make a mistake, let Washington have a shot at it. Get him right back in the ball game. Got to close it. That's Farkas again, and you see the quickness that he carries. Slashing in there, picks up 4.
A little more decisive than Sultan McCullough. McCullough's got more speed, but Farkas looks more like a running back in his cuts, especially with this style of offensive attack. But I doubt that Norm Chow would get conservative. That's not in his nature.
No, not really.
Especially with these weapons.
Thrown to Williams. Mike Williams, the ball comes out. Huskies pick it up. Bean bags have been thrown back around the 40-yard line. The return of the fumble is to just about midfield by Joe Lobendon.
And Derek Johnson will strip this ball from the freshman Mike Williams. And this is exactly what the Huskies were looking for. Get the ball back to their offense with good field position. Slant route to the outside. The catch is there. Watch the right hand and left hand, actually, of Johnson. And a good bounce for Lobendine here as he picks it up, and he's running. But Derek Johnson's had a long afternoon, but he makes up for it in one play right here.
Put it on the Washington 49, first down for the Huskies. Cody Pickett getting pressure, throws, trying to set a screen for Clemen. And Braxton Clemen will get it across midfield to the 47 of USC. That's 4 yards. Fourth quarter comebacks since Neuheisel has been at Washington. You can see there's a history there.
4 yards.
That's a lot of time, too. 12 minutes.
Pass is caught by Paul Arnold. It's a little short of the first down, it appears. Got a pretty good mark, though, from the man across the way.
Big number right here, those two interceptions. But Pickett is a competitor. He loves to get into a game where it's on his shoulders, and that's where it is right now.
Gets the first down. He gets it across the 40-yard line. He had to go across the 41, but he did enough to get his first down.
He made that first man miss about 3 yards deep in the backfield. So while he didn't get a lot of yards, he got what he needed. And now the Huskies will dictate tempo now with a no-huddle offense.
43 passes against 19 runs. Washington, that's pretty much on the schedule they've had all season. Pickett's pass is thrown to Clemen, and Braxton Clemen will bang his way down to about the 34.
He is a banger, too. He had a choice of going to the sidelines, trying to make a guy miss. He said, the heck with that. Lower the shoulder, lower the hat, punish the tackler. Second and four.
Gain six, needs four on second down. Ball thrown sharply and completed to Joe Toledo. That's his second catch of the ball game and his second catch of the season. First down, Huskies. Pittsburgh is the place, and the game involves the Steelers and the Indianapolis Colts. Tommy Maddox quarterbacking the Steelers right now. And, of course, Peyton Manning, Indianapolis. That'll be at 6 Pacific time. Cast your vote for Monday Night Football's greatest game at ESPN.com. The keyword, MNF 500 to the end zone. It is Reggie Williams, a touchdown. So the Huskies come up with a fumble and cash it in. At 10 minutes and 22 seconds to play in the game.
Keith, they got into a rhythm. They started dictating tempo of this game. Their play selection was better. And then they go for the big play, the bomb to Reggie Williams. Gets behind Marcel Almonds. A perfect pass. And down in time in the end zone for 6.
And the point after now coming up. John Anderson hits it low and squeezed it in. And it's now 34-21. We might have something cooking here.
Well, see you calling again. What could you possibly want? I thought that we could be friends, but now I know it wasn't fun. Yeah, I'm alright. This is the way that I was down. I'm trying to make it a business right, but I'm receiving no.
Blue, a new
Take pride in your odometer with Valvoline's Max Life. It helps keep higher mileage engines running for a long time.
Putting the ball on the tee at the 35-yard line. Deep for the USC Trojans, you'll have Marcel Aumann and Justin Fargus. Haven't been a whole lot of kickoffs returned today. This guy, he's been hammering it. So is Colleen, that's way back there, and it dropped in the end zone. They'll bring it out to the 20. And here's your quarterback comparison for the day.
Well, we talked about how much the ball would be in the air today. Cody Pickett is getting hot now, though. That last drive, he was 5 for 5. In fact, he's completed 11 of his last 12 passes. Palmer, having an outstanding afternoon, was victimized by Mike Williams fumbling after a long completion the last time SC had the ball.
Kareem Kelly is out as the wide receiver. So is Kerry Covert. And Sultan McCullough is the deep back and gets the ball. And the Huskies take him down after a yard with Ben Madavi, the middle backer, making the tackle for Washington.
Keith, that was really a strange reaction by McCullough. When he got the ball from Palmer, he stopped. Just almost came to a complete stop and then started again. Hole is off the right side. Maybe he stopped because he didn't know if he had the ball or not. That was a long handoff from Carson Palmer.
Ohio State Buckeyes beat Wisconsin 19-14 up at Madison today. Close, but they won it. Palmer trying to set up a screen here and a tight end screen, and was under. He let him come on through, trying to draw enough people with him, but only two Huskies went with him, and that left nine others to defend on the play, and they did a pretty good job of it.
And one of them was Ben Madavi putting pressure on Palmer. SC's offense looks horrible all of a sudden. In fact, their whole team looks horrible. It's amazing how momentum will swing, even when you have a huge lead, as the Ducks well know.
Yeah. They're down by 7. Arizona State added a field goal. Third down and 9. Ball's away and incomplete. Williams had drawn two Huskies and defending him, and Palmer had some pressure coming as Anthony Kelly and Kai Ellis were after him, and it was Ellis who put the lick on him. And so now the Trojans have to punt it away from inside the 10-yard line. And Washington, if they handle it, Frederick handles it all right, they'll have very good field position again with 9 minutes and 29 seconds to play in the game and trailing by only 13 points, 34-21. Malone gets it out of there. It's a low kick and not a particularly long one, but it takes a very good Southern California bounce. It's fielded by Frederick, and he brings it back 3 or 4 yards before he's run out of bounds. So it is still very good field position for Washington.
If you had but one wish, what would it be? World peace.
Go to CapitalOneBowl.com to vote for your favorite mascot to win the National Mascot of the Year scholarship.
What's in your wallet?
Nice wrench work, Chief. If more men would heed the call of the Y chromosome, maybe more of us would have three such faucets at our fingertips. Hot. Cold. And Miller High Life.
He's a loving father with a terrible secret. How far will he go?
Make sure no one will survive.
To cover his tracks.
Today.
A new Alias ABC Sunday.
Started out 7-7 first quarter, then the Trojans 17-7, and then the third quarter they added 17 more to lead 34-7, and now here in the fourth quarter, the Huskies have come back for 14 points, and it's an interesting score now. 34-21, and Washington will start this possession first down at their own 42-yard line. Time remaining in 9:19. And Pickett steps up quickly, throws quickly, and throws way behind the intended receiver, Charles Frederick. He missed him by 5 yards.
Yeah, he took a little hitch. He pump faked, and you can't afford that little pump there because you're going to throw it in either into coverage or throw it late. A slant route like that has to be delivered on time.
USC led this ball game 34-7 with 4 minutes and 56 seconds to play in the third quarter. We stifled a yawn and suddenly bang, bang. 34-21. Second down and 10. Pickett throws to his running back, Clemen, and Braxton Clemen is taken down by Simmons. Melvin Simmons has played very well for Southern California at that outside linebacker position. He transferred from Washington State, set out a year, and is doing very well here.
Yeah, he's their second leading tackler, and that was a terrific open field tackle where the running back goes down immediately.
It is third and 9. Trojan crowd trying to help their team. Pickett throws, got it to Reggie Williams. Boy, that Williams is a good receiver. He's a big guy, and spinning catch there in front of Deshaun Hill and move the chains to the USC 35-yard line.
And he beats double coverage here. It's a zone. Watch Allman pass him off. Hill comes over late. The ball is on a laser from Pickett.
Pretty good stuff there. First down and 10. And that's a bit clumsy looking as he tried to deliver the ball to Clemen out of the backfield and couldn't do it because there were all kinds of folks trying to kill him. 50 passes. How many times can you throw a ball in the season, Dan, before your arm falls off?
When you're 19 years old, 20 years old, or 35?
42-42, Arizona State and Oregon now. The Ducks have tied it.
You know, Cody has got a strong right arm because of all that healing he does as a team roper.
Trips at the top of the picture. Penalty flags away. They may have burned the clock.
Penalty flags? Yeah, the clock was against him, and they had to hurry, and people were moving up front.
You don't need to be doing that when you're trying to catch up this late in the game. It's hard to give up 5-yard penalties like that.
But Cody Pickett knows one thing. If he gets in trouble, he can look for number one, and Reggie Williams will reward that confidence.
Illegal shift on the offense. Penalties declined. Down to three.
You see, you saw Polamalu up there talking to Jace Crickets, the referee, and they decide, no. Let the play stand. They declined the penalty. And it makes it third down and 10.
Huskies have been awful good all year long converting third downs. Trojans had been a lot better than they are today defending third downs.
Pressure. pressure on Pickett. The pass is away. It's almost or may have been intercepted. No, it has not been intercepted. Mapolamalu was right there on it and couldn't quite scoop it up. So it is fourth down and 10. Well, the pressure forced Pickett out to the right. If he could have stayed to the left, he would have had Braxton Clement going right down the middle of the field there. Actually sneaking out of the backfield. There is Clement. And that's a heck of an effort by Troy Polamalu.
Timeout.
University of Southern California.
USC calls the timeout. Time remaining 8:18.
Old Navy painter's pants are one of a kind.
A better price you'd be hard-pressed to find.
Quality construction, that's our guarantee.
Old Navy painters,
you're the pants for me.
The price
is nice.
He'll wear
this pair.
Wow, they're just $15 to $20 for men and boys.
Old Navy, we are there.
Too close. What do you think? I got that insurance?
What insurance is that, Yogi?
Aflac. The one you really need to have. If you don't have it, that's why you need it.
Need what?
Aflac. Well, if you get hurt and miss work, it won't hurt to miss work. Uh-huh. And they give you cash, which is just as good as money.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Crunch time. There's Polamalu, who has to come out of the ball game. I'm sure that leg must be pretty tender by now. Jason Leach replaced him. He's a 5'11", 200-pound sophomore. Chino, he played pretty well, too.
Yeah, he's got a nose for the ball. He's got three interceptions this season.
So here we come with the Huskies, fourth and 10. Redder and Frederick. At the top of the picture, and here's Cody Pickett. Stepped away, almost sacked, got away. Throws, is it caught? Reddick down there at the 25-yard line, right on the marker, and they're saying no catch. Oh, my goodness, that was close.
You know, Reddick had to stay at the 25-yard line because that's what the Huskies needed for a first down. Watch him in the middle of the field. First of all, watch this move by Pickett to get away from Mike Patterson. And now here is Reddick right there. He comes back, but he knows he can't come back too far or they won't pick up the first down. Well, I've seen a lot of catches. That looked like a catch to me.
Well, there was one in the end zone last week that resulted in USC's first touchdown against California, and they ruled that one a catch, and it was the same kind of thing. But the officials were in different positions. Now USC trying to run some clock, and they start with Sultan McCullough. And McCullough will bring it out to the 43-yard line and a pickup of 8 yards.
Here's that catch you talked about last week against Cal. Kareem Kelly doing a great job of turning over, making like he made the catch, but clearly that ball hits the ground and then bounces into his chest.
But it was still 7.
Yep.
Jeff Tedford has still got a stomachache. Heck of a job by Jeff Tedford and his staff up there at Cal this year. It's just been fun to watch.
No question about it.
Just terrific.
Yep.
Ball is handed again to McCullough. And Sultan, he's going to be 2 yards short of his first down. So it'll be 3rd and 2.
Let's go back to Patrick Reddick's attempt to make this catch on a 4th down and 10. Throw back into the field. Both hands are underneath it. That's a catch. That's a catch. Watch both hands cradle this ball and keep it from hitting the ground.
I'm not going there. I can't tell.
Well, I'm biased, you know.
I understand.
Well,
you're a duck.
I'm a quarterback. That's a first down for Southern California. Malifo McKenzie out of the backfield. That's a big play. And now your clock stops at 6:30 to play. Why does Washington and Oregon have such enmity? Why is that rivalry so vibrant?
Well, how much time have you got? Well, let's see. Where do we start? Seattle, Eugene.
It's
bitter stuff, I'll tell you. Ball is resting now at the Southern California 48-yard line. They own it. They have it first down. They have a lead of 34-21. When the Huskies looked like they were coming back, they suddenly ran into a couple of plays that didn't do much for them and a couple of passes and were almost picked. And now they've got to try and stop the Trojans. Tomorrow, America's soccer champion is crowned on ABC Sports. The New England Revolution battling the LA Galaxy. 2002 MLS Cup tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. Pacific Time. ABC Sports Championship Television.
One of the most frustrated men out here this afternoon might be Sultan McCullough. Had 132 yards rushing against these Huskies last year. Got 35 so far.
Pretty well shut him down.
Yeah.
Second down and 10. Palmer puts air under it. Williams can't get it.
Pass is incomplete. Center for Mike Williams.
So the make or break game now grinds along as we go inside 6 minutes to play. The loser of this game will have two losses and seemingly would be pretty much out of the hunt for the conference championship. Executive producer of ABC Sports, Howard Katz. Senior producer of ABC Sports, Bob Toms. Coordinating producer of ABC's college football is Bob Goodrich. And these are the people I'll tell you in a minute who've done the game today and all season in the Pac-10. Third down and 10. Palmer, that one's good. Caught by Mike Williams, and that's close. It'll be good for a first down at the 40. Just less than 4 minutes to play at Eugene, Oregon, and it's still a 42-42 ball game between Oregon and Arizona State. Today's game produced by Mark Loomis, directed by Patrick McManus, associate producer Derek Mobley, associate director Jeff Kibler, our technical director John Zippe, our technical and production assistants, I should say, are Tom Wicks, Juliana Barberi, computer graphics Matt Jenkins, and Fred Amos. On first down, Palmer turns and gives it to McCullough. He breaks one tackle and fights his way down to about the 35. Time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report, scores and highlights around the country.
This is where it gets real dicey for a defense. You have to blitz every down now. Try to disrupt a handoff, strip the ball, create some type of turnover. But if you miss, there's nobody back there, and McCullough is the type of back who can make that one guy miss and go all the way.
Second down, call it 5. McCullough searching for daylight. And picks up about, he's 3 yards short of his first down. Being a tailback you, what is it involved? What is it like? Here's Sultan McCullough's comments.
The tough man is failed as a tailback. So you come there and see all the OJs, the Charles, and the Marcus Allens, you know that was the toughest guy on the field. So being a running back, you got to be the toughest SOB on the field. So eventually, you get to 26 carry, 28, you got to be running hard because you know at that time they're going to be tired. And you can see in their eyes they don't want it no more, and that's when you got to apply the pressure.
Well, he had 39 carries last week. Today he's had 20, a lot less yardage. But again, he's the man who could help control the ball, run off the clock, and win the ball game. Finishing our credits, our stage manager is David Hatter. Jeff Abramson is our booth A2.
and Kelly Hayes, as usual, our spotter. Thank you, sir, for a good job. And Mark Demento, who's taking a brief moment in his vast travels to spend an afternoon with us at the Coliseum, is our statistician. Good group. Great group. Just terrific. Camera guys, the whole bunch, they're just really good. Good people. 34-yard line for SC, third down and three. If they put it up. Nope. They give it to Justin Farkas, and Farkas just hammers in there, and he didn't get it. I tell you what, if you're an offensive lineman and that 210-pound running back coming with that speed and that power and whacks you, puts some tracks on your back, you want to get out of his way. He really popped somebody.
Yeah, it was one of those classic confrontations between tailback and middle linebacker. Ben Madavi stopped him cold. This is an interesting decision.
Yeah, fourth and three. Fourth down and three. Palmer throws it. Completes it. Kerry Colbert, first down. It's all the way down inside the 10-yard line. So, call it what you want. It worked.
Now, that's Norm Chow. And we talked about, would he become conservative? Fourth down and three. Game, perhaps in the balance. The pass protection, phenomenal. But the design of the play to get Colbert so wide open. He went in motion to the short side of the field. And Pete Carroll has got to love the play call and the execution.
That's Norm. He's a fun guy to spend an afternoon with. He really is. He's very clever. Trojans now knocking on the door again, and here's a loss on the play. Sultan McCullough trying to get to the line of scrimmage and can't do it as Marquise Cooper takes him down. Cooper has had a very good season for Washington at that outside linebacker position. Our studio show today, produced by Tim Weinkoff, directed by Calvin Haywood, and the technical director, Kevin Bierman. So I don't think I've missed anybody.
Well, who's the usher in section 34?
Okay. That's Charlie.
How about Miss Turian adding her support?
How about
as
that?
Well?
I would say yes. Grand companion. Great. Just great.
Here is touchdown. Justin Farkas. His first touchdown as a Trojan tailback. He's a senior. That is a big, big moment for him. And it's also very likely the door slammer for the Washington Huskies.
Yeah, Keith, you talked about how hard he hits that hole. How happy are his teammates for Justin Farkas?
He has struggled and struggled with injuries, and suddenly he's in hallelujah land, and let him celebrate. The kick is good. 3 minutes and 23 seconds to play now. 12 plays, 65 yards. And your score is now 41-21 USC. California trying to win their third conference game and go at 3-1. One of the undefeated, Oregon, is having a struggle with Arizona State up in Eugene. A 42-42 score there with a little over 2 minutes to play after leading the ball game 21-0. UCLA is playing at California. The other undefeated team, Washington State, idle this weekend. the kickoff by Colleen back into the end zone. He's going to run it out with Charles Frederick coming. Trying to go to the outside. Gets an alley. And he's finally run out of bounds. Up around the 45-yard line.
Well, special teams for Washington finally provides a big play there. But they had problems today. This is the first field goal attempt of the day. A high snap and a blocked field goal, and then the interceptions. The deflection picked off by Grotegood here, then Troy Polamalu returning this one 33 yards for the Trojans. And then on fourth down, a catch that was ruled not a catch.
Well, at 3:09, I would say this is the last gasp for the Huskies. They need something really quick, and then a quick turnover. There's the pass to Clemen. And he'll get it down to the Southern California 45. That's pretty close to a first down. There's another ball game being played here in the West today or tonight that kind of fun to look at. It's Central Washington against Western Washington. They will play their 90th game tonight. 90th. It's in Ellensburg.
Who do you like?
I don't know. Probably Central. They're at home. So Bellingham, where Western is located, we've spent a lot of time there too. So, don't know. But those are two very good programs. And the prize is the Cascade Cup. But that's a long time, you know, 90 years. You don't think in terms of schools like that, having been playing the game that long. But some of those Division II and III schools have played almost longer than anybody.
Yeah, great tradition.
Yep. Second down. And five. To the corner and beyond. Pickett put it high in the air, and Reggie Williams couldn't track it down. Up in the up yonder. The Goodyear blimp Spirit of America has been providing the aerial pictures today. 2002 marks the 104th, speaking of years, 104th anniversary of Goodyear and the 77th for their blimp fleet. Pilot today, Charles Russell, and the cameraman, Fabian Ochoa. Third and five for Washington. Whoa. Pretty good lick on Clemen by Pollard.
With the tackle.
Looks like he's got a first down.
First down.
Yeah, but not a whole lot of time left.
No. 2:39. The only thing that's different in college football is every time they pick up a first down from here on, now that clock's going to stop.
I like that rule too.
I do too. It adds to the anxiety. That ball is thrown very hard to Eddie Jackson, and he had no chance to catch it. Thrown high and behind him, and Deshaun Hill was trying to break it in two. Arizona State has now gained the lead over the Oregon Ducks. This will be the first loss of the season for Oregon unless something heroic happens for the Ducks. 45-42, and it's what, less than 2 minutes to play now.
Ducks have trouble with that 42. Last year, their only loss was to Stanford,
yep.
49-42.
Yeah, I did the game. It was 42-28 going into the fourth quarter. Pickett back. Runs away from the heat. Throws it. And it's short of the first down. He had nobody beyond the marker that he could get to. Charles Frederick makes the catch a yard short of the first down. Now they're going to say it wasn't caught. So he didn't have the handle all the way to the ground. Reggie Williams was deep, but he was covered up in Trojan shirts.
Yeah, and the other thing is that he was running from the right side of the field, and Pickett had already escaped the pocket to the left side. That would have been an impossible throw to get it all the way across the field to number one.
Now where's number one now? He's on this side, the near side. And he throws it to Clemen, and Clemen's going to be belted out of bounds, 3 yards short of the first down.
So they're going to be looking at fourth and three. He's caught 11 balls today, Clement has. Most of them, in fact, all of them, short passes. 2:09 to play in the ball game.
Braxton has rushed eight more times, but has only gained 12 yards on the ground.
Here it is. Dropped. That'll do it. 2:06. The Huskies have, each team, as a matter of fact, has two times out remaining.
The Trojans with pressure on the quarterback.
It's too late now for the Huskies.
Keith, we talked about what SC had to do. Carson Palmer, four touchdown passes, ties a career high, and they have pressured, pounded, and picked off Cody Pickett this afternoon.
Well, Southern California, in this instance, was a better football game. And the Trojans are going to take some handling. Washington State got them in Pullman. And down the road, that may turn out to be the biggest win of the season for the Cougars. They have a lot of trails to travel yet. All Washington can do is stop the clock twice with their times out. But they're down by 21 points. So the issue hardly seems in doubt. With a minute and 45 seconds to play. Matt Cassel now comes in there at quarterback. Carson Palmer is out. Mike Williams is out. Reserves are in to finish the game. You got to season them. And the guys behind Palmer haven't played much this year. I mean, almost none. Herschel Dennis is the deep back, and he'll get the ball. He's the freshman out of Long Beach Poly. And he cuts sharply for a yard, that's all. The Chevrolet players of the game today are Reggie Williams for Washington and Mike Williams for USC. And Dan is going to go home dreaming about the Williams folks tonight. Reggie Williams, 7 catches, 134 yards and a touchdown. For Mike Williams, 9 catches, 159 yards and 3 touchdowns. They're pretty good. All of them.
Certainly have lived up to their billing.
Yes, sir. Matt Cassel gives the ball away, and look at this move by Herschel Dennis. He is quick, and we're off to visit with John Saunders one more time.
Appears there will be no one undefeated in the Pac-10 when the day is done. Arizona State, after Mike Barth's field goal to give them the lead, Fife is picked up by Brett Hudson. Hudson gets it down inside the 5-yard line. In fact, Fife with the touchdown-saving tackle. Right now, they're just taking a knee for the victory. Arizona State leads it and looks like walk off with the win. Keith.
Wow, look at that. Andrew Walter, 521 yards.
Wow.
Holy smokes.
We were talking about the professor and the student. Dirk Cutter, great job.
But Walter, it's a sight, though. He's got some gunner. I mean, he's got some catchers to throw to. So it's a big upset in Eugene today as Arizona State beats the Oregon Ducks. First loss of the season for the Ducks. However, Arizona State and Washington State both stay undefeated in the conference, and the game is now over. 45-42, Arizona State. For USC, it's fourth down and 3, and they're going to punt the ball away with 40 seconds remaining in this game. And the Trojans trying to go 3-1, and they are headed for Eugene, and they'll find an angry bunch of Ducks waiting for them. Fair catch is called inside the 20-yard line at the 18. But Oregon's secondary is small. The safeties are pretty good. I mean, they're quite good. Keith Lewis is a terrific player. But they're young and they're small.
And they've given up 800 yards in passing the last 2 weeks. Carson Palmer, have you noticed that?
Yeah. Reggie, Mike Williams, have you seen that? And Kareem Kelly can't wait to get well. So we'll see what happens up in Eugene next week.
Taylor Martin at quarterback.
Taylor Barton is now the quarterback for Washington. It was Taylor Barton who came into the game a year ago in relief of Cody Pickett and had a terrific performance and set up the situation for John Anderson to beat USC 27-24. But today is another story. So the Huskies will now drop off to a record of 4-3. And they'll go 1-2 in the conference. USC will go 3-1 in the conference and 5-2 on the season. And the other big news of the day was Arizona State 45, Oregon 42, and it was in Eugene. Barton to throw it. Drop off to Clemens. Braxton's could make a living coming out of the backfield catching those little short passes. He's short of the first down, however. But he gets out of bounds, and that stops the clock at 20 seconds.
And SC would do everybody a favor, try and keep Mr. Clemens inbound.
Inbound. Especially Dan Fouch, who's trying to get to the airport.
I'll see you later, pal.
Okay, go ahead. I remember some others who did it once. One who left at the end of the third quarter.
I know many that would like to see me leave.
Martin, Taylor Martin throws it outside to Clement again. And this is just exercise here. Nothing to it more than picking up a first down and stops your clock at 11 seconds to play in the ball game. It is an academic fact that the University of Southern California Trojans have defeated the Washington Huskies on this afternoon. And right now the score sits at 41-21.
How about 14 receptions? The new Husky record for Clemens.
15.
15 now.
And that'll do it. The game is over. So Pete Carroll walks off with a light step as his football team wins by a score of 41-21. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com. The keyword, ABC Sports. And don't forget, Monday night at 6 Pacific, the Indianapolis Colts and the Pittsburgh Steelers on ABC's Monday Night Football. Keith Jackson, Dan Fouts, Todd Harris. Goodbye till next Saturday. Yeah.